Hello everyone, welcome to the Curiosity Club. Recently, there's been a very popular TV series adapted from a game called Fallout, which depicts a post-nuclear world where humans establish multiple underground shelters to evade radiation. The story unfolds as humans above and below ground vie for resources and strive to survive in the aftermath of nuclear war. While the TV series is fictional, it indirectly references a real-world experiment that sparked considerable controversy, piquing my curiosity. This experiment is called the Universe 25 experiment, Universe 25, a utopia for mouse. Get ready, because in today's video, we will describe a world composed of mouse. This was actually an experiment conducted by an American human and animal behaviorist John B. Calhoun. The experiment is known as the Universe 25 experiment. Calhoun was famous for his research on the effects of population density on human behavior. During his tenure at the National Institute of Mental Health in the United States, he studied what might happen when population growth peaks in conditions of abundant resources, using mouse as subjects, creating a well-known mouse utopia. This utopia had an area of about 2.7 square meters, divided into 16 cells. Each cell had four vertical mesh tunnels on the fence walls, providing mouse with a continuous supply of food and water, as well as comfortable living spaces and suitable temperatures, with no predators. In short, this utopia was designed specifically for mouse to live happily. However, theoretically, it could only accommodate a maximum of 3,840 mouse living together. Initially, four pairs of mouse, that is, four males and four females, aged 48 days, were introduced as the first residents of Universe 25. After spending some time adjusting to each other and their environment, the rats joyfully began mating. At first, the number of young mouse increased rapidly, doubling by day 55. Then the growth continued exponentially, 20, 40, 80, 160, 320. By day 315 of the experiment, there were 620 mouse, roughly 80 times the original population, marking the prosperity phase, referred to as Phase B. By this stage, some structured social hierarchy among the rats had formed, with their own circles and organizations. From day 315 to day 560, a period of 145 days, known as Phase C, the mouse continued to reproduce, but the rate of increase slowed compared to Phase B. By the end of Phase C, the population reached 2,200, after which it stopped growing. Despite still having space for more mouse within the maximum capacity of 3,840, the population entered a decline phase, termed Death Phase D. Why Death Phase? Because starting from day 560, the growth in mice population abruptly ceased. In other words, deaths outnumbered births. After day 600, no new young mouse were successfully born, and even if they were, they did not survive. By day 920, the last instance of mice reproduction occurred, after which there were no more births. On May 23, 1973, 4 years and 10 months after the initial four pairs entered Universe 25, the last mice in the utopia died, marking the end of Universe 25. During the observation period, apart from the prosperous Phase B, researchers observed changes in rat behavior during Phases C and D. During Phase C, due to the increase in the rat population, many young mouse reached adulthood. Normally, in the ecosystem, once a group of young animals matures, they need to replace the aging previous generation in the population. Those who fail in the competition would leave their group and search for their own survival space outside. However, in Universe 25, the situation was different because the failed mouse had nowhere to go. Thus, a phenomenon emerged where the failed rats became passive both physiologically and psychologically. The males tended to gather in a central circle on the floor of the universe. They stopped socializing and bore many scars, often from attacks by other failed rats, as they had to leave the center circle to eat and then fight to secure their own space when they returned. As for the failed females, they typically sought refuge in higher nests that were not favored by other females. On the other hand, the male mouse that successfully competed for territory, because they drove away their competitors, became less defensive about their territory over time. Conversely, the female mouse in the reproductive or lactation periods became increasingly aggressive to protect themselves. Ultimately, this led to females being more aggressive, often attacking their own offspring, and many young rats leaving their nests before weaning. Additionally, many females moved around with their offspring, abandoning many of them. Thus, the decrease in fertility and the increase in the death rate of young were the main reasons for the decline in the population. There was another interesting phenomenon during this period. Corresponding to the decrease in fertility in females was a group of narcissistic males, which researchers called beautiful ones. These male mice never mated with females or engaged in fights, so they had no scars. All they did was eat, drink, sleep, groom themselves, and look good. Most of the mouse in the latter stage of Universe 25 were similar to these beautiful ones and non-reproducing females. Later, researchers transferred some of these rats to less crowded spaces and introduced suitable mates, but these so-called beautiful ones remained the same, showing no change. The conclusion drawn from this experiment was, when all available space is occupied and social roles are fixed, the pressure brought about by competition leads to the complete collapse of complex social behaviors in individuals, ultimately resulting in social collapse. Calhoun believed that what happened to the mouse in this experiment had certain metaphors for the potential fate of humanity in the future. This conclusion is somewhat unsettling, isn't it? However, there have been many objections. Some critics argue that the environment set in the Universe 25 experiment was not realistic because in the natural world, animals have more choices, such as escaping, and are also influenced by more external factors. Furthermore, directly comparing rat behaviors with human social issues can be misleading and cannot be directly used as a reference. In conclusion, this experiment does provide some interesting food for thought, but opinions may differ, and there's no need for excessive interpretation. Okay, that's it for today. See you next time.